the one, the only, Chris Carlin!
And hey, what's guys, up, my friend? Great to be back. I don't know why my computer always lags for these calls, but my phone is like, let's go. So
Johnny on the spot. Let's
go. We're going phone today.
Well, you sound good. We see you. It's been a while. So before we dive in, because we're keeping you here for three box breaks tonight. Guys were kind enough to send us Premiere and Anime releases this week. And I held the second box of Marvel Masterpieces for when you would be on next. We're gonna look at all three of those. And but before we dive into box breaks, let's catch up a little bit on Upper Deck, because it's been your wheelhouse as far as the company is concerned, in the sense that we had Stanley Cup, draft, free agency. It's all been happening in the last few weeks and currently still happening. What does that mean for the company right now?
Well, first and foremost, it is so nice to have sports back, right? Like, I've
been
some serious withdrawals. When you're binge watching, when you're like, God, when can I get the next Michael Jordan documentary out? Like, you know that things have gone crazy. So it's been great to have all sports back. Hockey in particular was really well executed, I thought. It was fun to see some teams that are not normally in it. I know a few Dallas collectors that were really excited. I know some of the guys at Beckett were really excited about how well they were playing. Tampa Bay is just tough. And I love at Tampa Bay. There's a lot of cool patches out there. I love that we had some guys who weren't hobby superstars yet, you know, like a Victor, like they had some hobby love, but they weren't at that upper echelon level. So for Steven Stamkos to get a cup, for Victor Hedman to win the Conn Smythe, for other players like Kucherov and others and Andre Vasilevsky to get some love for, you know, winning Lord Stanley's Cup was fantastic. But you're right. Then it was like, okay, here's the draft. And our team worked really hard. You know, the draft is always one that I didn't used to go to. And then when I started going to it, I was like, wow, there are so many cool opportunities to engage collectors, to engage our fans.
Oh, yeah.
And we always have a lot of fun there. But, you know, it was like one of those moments where you had to take a step back and figure out how we're gonna do this year. And our team, Paul Wynn in particular, were amazing with regard to getting product placement. I don't know if you saw St. Louis Blues had Upper Deck cards in their
cards draft room. Cards on the draft table. Yeah, I saw it.
Yeah. Alexi had Upper Deck stuff throughout. And I remember one of the grandmas is holding an Upper Deck pillow. So there's a lot of different product placement, which is really cool. But just everything that we had going on with regard to Alexi Lafreniere and Quentin Byfield was awesome. And for us to be able to announce and lock up the top two draft picks so early and to not only exclusive deals, but spokesman deals. So it's pretty cool that they're going to have trading cards and memorabilia coming out. And we don't do that frequently with NHL draft picks. Usually we'll do an autograph deal or things along those lines. But I hope it goes to show how much we believe in this rookie class coming up. And I got to tell you, it's a crazy time in our industry for sure. But get ready for hockey to make some serious noise this season, because those two young guns are going to be a lot of fun to watch. And what's fun about hockey is there's always a few players that kind of come out of nowhere. And you're like, wow, this guy's amazing too. So and some of the changes that have been going on, Taylor Hall going to the Sabres, and some of the movement that we're seeing now with free agency, Lundqvist going to the Capitals, Holtby going to the Canucks. It's just like, whoa.
Corey Crawford, you know, going to what, New Jersey? And
our checklist guys are like, okay, we got to get this going here. How are we going to make this happen?
Well, so that's always a lot of fun. Speaking of the production side of things, I mean, I know you guys have utilized the draft in past years to gather a tremendous amount of content that you guys will use, not only in physical products, but also in marketing those products. Everything from acquiring autographs and photos and whatnot. So peel back the curtain a little bit, take us into the boardroom of your roundtable discussions and what's being done to replace that this year.
Well, yeah, I mean, events like Rookie Showcase didn't happen. And that's not just for us. That's for everyone. So, Panini, you know, they're not going to run the football one. So there's just a lot of situations that are making it a bit more difficult. But I think we, Upper Deck has always done kind of our best work when our back's against the wall. And luckily, you know, by having Lafreniere as a spokesman and the deal with Byfield, that allows us some incredible access to those two athletes. I don't know if you guys saw the video we did with Alexi, but Upper Deck was one of the first people to get him in a Rangers uniform, get him on the ice, and have that ready to roll. So we're acquiring content, we're acquiring materials, we're acquiring signatures on the daily. And it's going to be weird, though, in that, you know, right about now, gosh, the season would be, you know, pretty much getting ready to start here. So,
right.
So with the delay to the season, there's going to be some delays to products. You know, artifacts would have been out by now. So we're just going to see some slight delays with products. Upper Deck Series 1 is usually the first week of November. It's going to be mid-November. But then they're going to start coming out pretty fast and furious once they do get on the ice. And I think it's just going to be a lot of fun this season to collect, to enjoy, and to just watch some of the new releases that are coming out from Upper Deck.
Do me a favor. I don't know how many people pay this much attention to the progress of the hobby. But, you know, Upper Deck keeps putting out new technologies, new cards, new product configurations. But we're also seeing a lot of online integration and innovation from other companies. However, Upper Deck with EPAC was kind of at the forefront of that. Tell me a little bit about how you've seen the technology integration over the last 6 months. You know, if there's been any changes, any updates, any exciting new programs this year, especially with not having the in-person activations, that you can sort of go into for us with Upper Deck.
Yeah, well, we're about to launch a major upgrade to EPAC that should be hitting next week. So I want to encourage everyone, if you have tried EPAC before and you were like, I don't know, when this hits, I think it's going to be this Tuesday, definitely go back on there and give it another spin, because the team has been, we wanted to have this hit in the spring and, you know, what happened there. So it's been delayed, but some of the upgrades that we've made to that platform are quite significant. They're going to allow a lot more efficiencies. And, you know, for me to be laying in a bed at night and just being like, I can't sleep, like, to be able to open up a couple packs, that's awesome. To be able to trade cards with the guy in Japan, that's amazing. And before this, we knew this was finally coming. My customer care team did some outbound calls to our EPAC customers. And for us, it's nice. You know, I always heard before when I was managing customer care, hey, I've got this really big customer, you know, when I'm talking to a shop, but I don't know if that guy's really buying at the level that they say, or I've got this lady who's just totally into the Marvel cards. I'm taking their word for it. And I believe in our shops and that's fine. But to be able to actually see, oh my gosh, this guy's spending a lot, you know, opened two cases today. And that gives us a lot of feedback. But for us, we thought it was really important to reach back out to those customers and just find out what they thought of the experience so far and to just, you know, engage with them a bit more. Let them know, hey, we're here if you ever have issues. But just some of the stories that we got coming out of that about what some of these collectors do and how they engage on EPAC. You know, one collector was telling us he works on an oil rig in the Arctic Circle. And he's opening up packs of cards when it's 60 degrees below outside. And
that's awesome.
Yeah. Another collector's telling us, you know, he's waiting on service calls, you know, hanging from wires, waiting for his tools to come or something to happen, something to be turned on. He's cracking some boxes and making some trades. So for me to be able to hear these stories, you're like, oh my God, that's awesome.
Yeah.
But then, you know, another guy was amazing. He was a funeral director and he's like, you know, my job, like it weighs on me what I do. And sometimes, you know, just in between, it gives me an escape. It gives me a break. And I thought that was really unique and kind of cool too. So
that's a whole new really spin on the term box break, right? It's really yes. giving him a break.
Yeah. So, you know, it's cool to see the way that our collectors have adopted it. But what's really cool about the platform is, you know, as you look on at online platforms, you know, licensing can expire or licenses change. What's cool about EPAC is once it's on there, it's on there. It's you know, it's basically a marketplace. So now that we have so many new products up there, you know, Disney just went out. And so it's bringing in a new wave of collectors. But what I find really interesting is seeing the cross trading that goes on, where you have someone trading Grandeur coins for Goodwin Champions, and then so that person changing, you know, trading for Marvel, you know, Marvel trading cards and Alien and X-Files and, you know, for Upper Deck dinosaurs, dogs. You know, there's just so many different things that have been added to the platform since it began. It's really cool to see. And
I am so guilty of flipping puppies on ComC.
Well, I know that I there, nothing can replace the fun and excitement of going into a shop. I've got a family road trip coming up this week, and I'm going to hit a few shops along the way for sure. But when you don't have that, or when you're just a little freaked out, or God, if you're quarantining, EPAC's an awesome solution. So upperdeckepac.com, definitely check that out this Tuesday. We've got some major upgrades going on in there.
Because just in case people missed it, you get physical cards. Yes, you're opening them online, but they are reflective of physical cards that you own.
Why would I want these physical cards?
Yeah, you get.
No, it's real cards. You can have them shipped to you. You can send them over to ComC. You could sell them. So there's it's a very dynamic platform. And the cool thing is. What I love about it is a lot of the cards you're seeing aren't just a stock image. It's if you see that autograph, if you see that patch, that is a scan of your actual card. So you know that, oh, I've got a multi-colored patch here, or I've got that autograph is flawless. So it's I really think that is something that was way ahead of its time.
Very cool. Well, speaking of cards, it's definitely time to look at some Upper Deck cards, because one of the coolest products of the year on the NHL calendar is Premier Hockey, year in and year out. And we happen to have some right here to look at.
Now, before you show this, Rob, I just want to give a little tidbit or a fun fact about this release.
Okay.
Every year, Premier is in tins. And the tins we get from overseas. And obviously with the pandemic, you know, you couldn't have that. So we packaged it in a very similar fashion to Ultimate Collection, which is great, but there've been a lot of questions about the cup. The cup will be in tin. So we were able to secure those. We do those a bit earlier, and just a fun fact for you and with regard to the differences, but I actually like the packaging this year. It's a little quicker to get into and enjoy. So with that being said, let's dig in.
Well, boom, right off the bat, Stanley Cup winner, rookie Anthony Cirelli, auto.
Wow.
Very nice. He's been a nice surprise for that team, and he's got a few people that are definitely PCing him, so I'm sure you're going to have them asking how they can get that card tonight for sure.
Another cool thing about this product, I'm reading, am I reading this right? Every patch is from a game used jersey?
Correct. All game used. And this seems to be a Stanley Cup pack. So another tip.
Yeah. Nikita Kucherov base.
So we're talking about him. Amazing scorer. And someone who's getting more hobby love these days, which is good.
Premier rookie, numbered to 199. Capo Caco.
You know, and if you're looking to prospect hockey right now, the New York Rangers are a really good team,
right?
Back on, because you've got a really, really stellar young goalie in Igor Shesterkin. There, you've got Capo Caco, you've got Adam Fox, you've got Artemi Panarin, and now we're going to have Alexi Lafreniere and a couple others. So the Rangers are a good team to maybe dig into right now.
Matthew Tkachuk, Premier Swatches, jersey card numbered to 99.
Very nice. Yeah, Kachuk, the son of Keith Kachuk, his brother Brady plays with the Senators. So Matthew is one of the more physical players in the NHL and a lot of fun to watch. He doesn't have a lot of fans on other teams.
This box is the bomb. Capo Caco.
Oh, wow.
Near jerseys, numbered to 49.
Very nice.
Hold that another second for me. Beautiful.
And then when you said this is a Stanley Cup box,
man,
you were not kidding. How about a rookie auto patch of Tampa Bay Lightning Carter Verha? Huh. Numbered to 149, and that's an on-card autograph.
Look at that patch. This is so nice.
Beautiful patch. And then you're not going to believe this, Chris. Premier Signatures Acetate Silver Ink Andre Vasilevsky
of Tampa Bay Lightning. That's crazy. Vasi.
That card is beautiful. Look at the thick.
Wow.
Yeah, but are goalies any good in the hobby?
Yes.
Yes, there's a lot of people that PC goalies, and Vasilevsky is definitely one of the brightest young stars in the NHL. So, yes. All right.
So what we're going to do, because this is a lesson that I learned only recently. You know, I thought that goalies in hockey were like goalies in soccer and defensive people in the NFL. I didn't realize that they were actually some of the hottest. Yeah, they're super hot. So,
all right,
Russ Cohen, correct me on that.
Four giveaway winners tonight from the Premier Box. Obviously, the Vasilevsky, the patch auto of Carter Farrell, the Premier rookie auto of Anthony Cirelli, and then we're going to pair up the Capo Caco cards for one winner. So four different winners out of that box. Holy cow, Chris.
Yeah, and just to dispel any rumors, because I know when we get, I always hope when we break boxes, like it's just okay. You know, it's not bad. It's not great. That was a great pack. So we don't know what's in the packs. You know, they go out. It's hard enough for us to get a release out on time sometimes. So we don't have a way of telling, but yeah, that's
cool. It's true. These come, I mean, the return address on here is the printing facility. It's never Upper Deck. So I can quickly dispel any.
I would have kept that back.
I don't want to throw you under the bus, Chris, but yeah, we have gotten enough duds that we do know. But that said, it's always fun when we get one like this, a Stanley Cup and hot rookie box of NHL Premier. And again, we didn't talk about it enough. Every patch is a game worn jersey patch. None of that 27 jerseys on a guy.
Yeah, and the mega patches in particular are very popular there for sure. So,
So very cool.
Before we dive into Marvel anime, can I just say a couple things about Marvel trading cards as of late?
Yeah, let us know.
Absolutely. Please do.
You know, we've seen a huge spike in interest in sports cards across the board, right? But the other thing that has been picking up, like, a lot is Marvel trading cards. And it says something about the property and just how hot all the films have been. But what we have seen is with EPAC, not a lot of shops were carrying entertainment products. And not a lot of fans who liked these products could get them very easily. But now with EPAC, you can just go on your phone, go to upperdeckepac.com, open up a box, a case, which we definitely see. And there's a lot of trading and there's a lot of interest. There's achievements and things along those lines. If you put together a set, you can get these cool sketch cards. So the visibility and the interest in Marvel, we have seen a huge spike in interest in the last, definitely since COVID, but before that, I think it was about a year where interest and just how do I get more of this? Marvel Premier is definitely one. Masterpieces is one. Premier is one. And anime is a new release. And what we found is it's really, this is kind of embracing the worldwide phenomena of anime. And you see this a lot in Asia, a lot of interest in anime. So while this is a product that we made for everyone, it was designed with some international distribution. But when we open this, you'll definitely see there are so many fun inserts and so much fun content that it's pretty much for everyone. So I was watching some of this being opened with my sons. My sons love watching the Marvel packs be cracked, and it's just a fun release. So let's check out and see what we get. 90 card base set. The cards are horizontal in nature, so that's a base Iron Man.
Rocking. Yeah, it's funny you bring that up, Chris, because you know I've only got so much bandwidth. Rob only has so much bandwidth. I've seen friends have been tweeting me, hey, you know, comics are exploding like cards are. And yeah. I see it. I just can't, you know, I can't add one more thing to track.
Yes.
But so I, you know, it's great to hear that because I had not connected the dots that, well, how is that impacting comic cards? Ooh, look at that shiny one.
Look at that parallel.
That's beautiful. But it is really cool because I've always felt like that was an underserved market. You know, there's a few comic shops in LA. I walked into one pre-quarantine and lockdown, and he didn't have cards. And I was like, you know, you could just talk to Upper Deck and get a few boxes and have them here. People might buy
that's
it.
Something, or that's something. GTS.
GTS is a great resource if you're a shop and you're looking to dip your toe in the water on the Marvel releases. GTS can definitely help you there too.
It's something I've never understood when I walk into a comic book shop and I don't see entertainment trading card products. And part of that problem, Ivan, is if it's not in the Diamond catalog, owners can't be bothered with it. But the ones that educate themselves are doing a wonderful service. Oh, we got one of the Stax cards.
Ooh.
Oh, yeah. This is a really cool one. So for this, you're basically, I think it's three levels. You put together three different levels of a trading card, and it makes like a cool scene. So different levels of rarity on those, but definitely a fun one for sure.
Yeah, and that's another reason to use GoGTS.net whenever you open Upper Deck products, because we have all the different tiers. Every insert that you guys do in these products, well, most inserts, there's like some that are more common and others that are super rare. And you don't always know just from looking at it. You really gotta look up.
Yeah.
Scarcity.
You know, I want to just tell you guys a quick story while we're doing this. You know, when I was a young kid growing up and, you know, being dropped off at the baseball card shop, I would just buy baseball card, baseball card, baseball card, release after release, while I watched in the 80s the basketball, the football, the hockey cards just sit there. And, you know, 10 years later, what we saw is, you know, there was a lot more baseball cards than there were basketball, hockey, and football. So I think we're poised to see something very similar happen with Marvel, where it's been niche releases for all these years. And now with the popularity, with them about to go into the next wave of their theatrical releases, going into multiverse, things along those lines, you're going to see a lot of enhanced interest in Marvel releases. And people will go back and try to find these products, and they're just not going to be there. So I would definitely, if you're one of those newbies to the category that's looking to prospect, putting a couple boxes of Marvel away is not a bad idea at all.
Two stat cards in one box. This is the the magenta. Too bad it's not
very nice.
Too bad it's not. It doesn't pair up with the other one.
We're going to give
both of these stack cards away, though, for sure, because someone's going to be able to either trade or sell for good money to somebody who wants to build this. I like the idea of building it. I'm going to have to check out the stack checklist and see if there's if Elektra, Daredevil, Punisher, Black Widow are on there, I might have to go all in. And
you know, and that's another funny thing that we see is that the people, just like in sports cards, people PC their favorite characters, you know.
It's true.
There are people that PC that. There's people that PC Spider-Man. So it's interesting. There's people that PC the X-Men. So every release, it's kind of interesting to hear people talk the same way they do in the sports category about Marvel releases. And screw it.
Speaking of X-Men, you guys just solicited Metal Universe X-Men. How cool is that going to be?
Yeah, so that'll be, I believe it's a Skybox. We're using the Skybox brand for that. So, yeah, having PMGs and all sorts of other things, all that content that was so fun in the 90s to bring it back for this. And that's near and dear to my friend Mike Phillips's heart, who's our VP of sales. He used to work with FLIR. To be able to have that knowledge base of people who worked on some of those sets and to make sure that they stay true to what they were is really kind of cool. That's awesome, Defenders.
This is awesome, too. We got a character capsules card. To tear or not to tear, Chris?
Oh.
Well, I think we have to, right?
Yeah, I think we have to. Inside this Dyson card are numerous possibilities. Look for a character from the X-Men to discover what's inside. Open the card using the perforated line on the back.
Okay, so Rob, here's what you have to do.
Okay.
You have to flip that back over. Let me get a picture of it.
All right, there's the front.
And we have to wait until the end of this to rip that. Because
okay,
I want to
okay.
tweet it out and let people like know, hey, you want to see okay. what's inside?
Fair enough.
Come check it out. All right. So give it just those a few cars, minutes. Let it marinate. But that's pretty freaking cool.
Such anxiety. I'm like, oh.
Dude, this
but
is.
But you have to rip it. But you just, it's. Did you get another one?
I got another one, Chris.
The heck?
I got a hot box.
Guardians of the Galaxy. I swear I don't know what's in these boxes. That's so crazy.
Wow.
That is awesome. All right.
Want me to hold both of them, Ivan?
Yeah.
No, it's fine. I already got the tweet going out, so all people right. will be okay, double okay. surprised.
All right. So we're going to do this.
Yeah, because I have no clue what's inside these either. It's sort of a different take. Tell us where that capsule. I know that it's in the anime tradition, but what is capsule? Like, where does that whole thing come from?
You know, reminds me of the advent calendars. You know,
right? Mm.
I've always wanted to do a hobby advent calendar, but it's just they're very expensive to do cards like this.
Oh, wait, you're ripping it already?
We have
two. He's doing the Guardians of the Galaxy.
Oh. I just asked you, do you want to
I was in the middle of tweeting.
And you said, no, that's okay.
You gave
okay.
us the green light. Twitter's broken anyway, Ivan. Come
no,
on.
No, I thought you were asking if I needed a picture of both of them. All right. Ooh, well, that looks cool inside, though.
Mantis Mini. Oh, and it's sleeved and everything. How cool is that? Capsule characters mini. So we got Mantis of Guardians of the Galaxy, as indicated there, and other ones to look for.
So I love that the team was able to do that, because so often when you do rip into those, the card gets damaged. So to have it sleeved inside is a really nice, nice touch, I think.
Absolutely. And you can even... You know, if you open it carefully enough, like I did, the perforations are such that you really don't ruin the overall aesthetic of
the outer shell
itself. Yeah, because that just goes back like that, and that's really cool. But we still have one more to come. And it's still in that pack was a base card, and we have okay. more packs to go.
So I'm looking at the checklist to try and get this. So there are numbered parallels of the rip cards and of the minis.
There she is.
Oh, Black Widow. My kids have been waiting for this movie to come out forever.
I know. So is my daughter. Ooh, look at this parallel. What is this called? This is cool. It's got this.
That Ultron?
Rural design on it. Yes, that is Ultron. And it's got this amazing swirl on it. It's really
why cool. weren't cards this cool when I was a kid?
Right.
I don't know. Well, maybe it's when you were a kid, Chris. I was going to say, I was a kid in 1993. So I remember 91. I remember the original Skybox Marvel card. So
yeah,
there was some cool foil in
those
there.
Those were quite cool.
Daredevil.
So, there's Daredevil.
Here comes another really sparkly parallel.
But yeah, so in the minis, there are parallel versions. So there could be rare parallels inside. So that's one reason to rip. It's not just those. those ones.
What was the decision to go with an all horizontal set? You don't see that very often.
You know, I think they were looking at really making this a different type of trading card set. And again, kind of looking at some of the trends that they see over over in Asia. So it was a different concept, but this is definitely a different type of set for sure.
I like it. And really,
I mean, you'll see, we found some of the inserts, but there's some really just fun content in here. So buying on the on a multi-box level, you're going to have a really fun pack opening experience.
Well, I have to admit, when you guys debuted this at
the CDD conference, yeah, I was excited
in January. Yeah. I was a little bit skeptical and vocal. You might remember, I never hesitate. Yeah, yeah. And I have to say that I've been happy as a Marvel fan on the record. I've been happily proven wrong. This is very cool. And when you see this next card, you're absolutely going to go gaga. Boom. Fin Fang Foom artist autograph?
That's awesome.
JP. Oh man, where are my glasses?
He signs in the gold, which is really nice. So it pops a bit.
Yeah, and it's numbered to only 60.
Wow, so cool.
Wow, this box has crushed it, man. And it's not over yet. Looks like the Go GTS Live shipping department's going to have another busy weekend. Great characters, great inserts, great.
You know, and just talking about shipping, just real quick. Oh, that's cool too. You know, I just want to thank all the collectors out there who've been so patient, not just for Upper Deck, for a lot of other companies too, and for ComC. You know, when COVID hits, you know, when you're shipping out thousands of packages a day, you really have to change your business model and in order to even open up. So a lot of companies, I know us and many others are dealing with. Oh yeah, is that?
Yeah, it's the bottom tier of a stacks card.
Yeah.
So we have seen the there's three levels. Two tops. We've seen two there's top four. Layers and oh, there's four. Okay. Yeah. So we've seen two of the top layers and then the bottom layer. This one is for Hulk Avengers. That's incredible.
Yeah, they're actually labeled CMYK. I can guess at the first three. I don't know what the K stands for.
Black.
But so that's cool. So, but again, just thanks to all the fans who've been patient for redemptions as we work. You know, people used to work shoulder to shoulder, and you can't have that anymore. So I know that's with ComC. I know that's with every company, but just appreciate fans' patience there.
Juggernaut.
Oh, that's a cool one.
Deadpool mechanized. That's cool.
Yeah, we just got a comment from Justin in the chat that this box is definitely worth the MSRP. Yeah, freaking A. You put effort into this. It's I mean, we're going to look at the other incredible Marvel Masterpieces box here shortly. But man, you really put the art into this one in a great different way.
You know, and different style than Masterpieces. Ivan, you know, you're a dad with young kids. I'm a dad with young kids. And Rob, your kids are a little older, but they definitely still love this stuff. So, you know, you think about hobbies that you could do when you're stuck inside, and sharing the Marvel cards in particular are, it's just a lot of fun to be able to sit down with your kids and share the hobby. And it's a fun way to get them into, you know, if hockey's your sport, baseball, football, whatever it is down the line, to just teach them about trading cards.
Quick moment of silence for Chadwick Boseman as we look at a Black Panther card.
Thank Wakanda you. Forever.
Wakanda forever.
Hey, Chris, can I put you on the spot for a minute? Tell me if you can't answer this. But I thought that I saw some stuff. I've seen collectors say that they did too, but I just want confirmation. We have a question in the chat. Do we know if Lafreniere is in Upper Deck Series 1? Is there
going to be releasing the checklist on that very soon. I think possibly as early as next week. As everyone knows, usually the player has to skate in an official NHL game before they can have a rookie card produced. With that being said, Lafreniere is a spokesperson. Obviously, we're living in some strange times, so we've been in discussions with the NHLPA about that. I cannot officially say tonight, but if I was a Rangers fan, I would be buying as much Series 1 as I could get right now. I would just say that. Does that answer? Is that good enough, Ivan?
That's definitely a good enough answer
for me.
Okay.
I have a level of trust.
We got a Captain America Black stack card.
Yeah. What are the odds on these stack cards? They're like one in every pack. This is freaking awesome. We're going to have our work cut out for us.
Well, you know,
building this together.
You can grab them, but then you've got to grab the other aspects of it too. Mm-hmm. So there's a level of chase to this. Absolutely.
So what we're going to do, we're going to have.
I kid on that because the lowest level is 1 in 16. So we definitely got a hot box with that as well.
One winner, Ivan, is going to get all four stacks cards to give them some trading ammo to try to – or a start to decide to put one together. Okay?
Okay. That's cool. So the winner that gets that is going to get all four, so you can either try to build the one, which is fun, through trading, or, you know, build all four.
And then – another one gets the Kaiju Fin Fang Foam artist autograph. Another winner is going to get the capsule character card that we tore earlier. And
we got one more to do.
And we're going to tear this one with my handy dandy Upper Deck.
Who's on that one?
Cutter. This one is X-Men.
You know, I can't make any more of those cutters, unfortunately. Legal is too concerned that someone's going to hurt themselves. So don't hurt yourself for starters. But
are you serious?
If you find those are a great little collectible in and of
itself. You're being SSP. Serious?
SSP.
You know, if GTS wanted to make some, that would be great.
Let me introduce you to the lawyers. That's pretty cool. Let me get the video back up so I can watch this.
You got that down now.
Oh, yeah. I don't want to ruin the capsule itself. All right. Look at that. Storm.
Cool.
Yeah, that's awesome. And let's clean that up a little bit there. No, the design team did an awesome job. The perforations are clean. And with that in a little tobacco sleeve, and it all just goes back together perfectly. All right, so 1, 2, 3, 4 winners from this box.
I love it. Awesome. And then we've got one more exciting Upper Deck Marvel box here. 2020 Marvel Masterpiece.
Now,
so we could show this one, but the crazy thing about this product is when it comes out, it is so widely opened that it doesn't last long. So it is hard to even find a box of this right now. So definitely a stellar release. We used artist David Palumbo. He created the art for the entire base set. And you know, we are very careful about who we select on this. We give them a lot of time, and the art on each card is like a really compelling insert card because it's so good. So this is gonna be a lot of fun to check out the Skybox Marvel Masterpieces.
One more product you guys solicited just this week was another Marvel product, brand new to your portfolio. Black Marvel Black Diamond, going to be incorporating some of the beloved themes from Black Diamond into a Marvel product. And Mike Phillips said that we're supposed to get a color sell sheet this week. So we should have some images to share on GoGTS.net. The base details are up, but no images yet.
Yeah, and we've actually produced it before. The exquisite cards are very popular. So yeah, that's a fun one for sure. All right, let's rip into this bad boy though. Nice thick packs. I believe it's 3 cards per pack. But each card is numbered. Very thick cards, very premium. I believe each card is numbered to $14.99 for the base set. So again, there's just not much of this.
Beautiful. Boom, boom. Incredible Hulk cover. Numbered to $9.99. Boom, boom. Was numbered to $9.99 as well. And Moon Knight gold script.
Yeah, we're going to be hearing more about Moon Knight. They're working
on
stuff with them as well.
Who's your favorite Marvel character, Chris?
You know, I love when I was collecting, I didn't collect a ton of comic books, but I love the Daredevil series. And I thought the Netflix show for Daredevil and Punisher were really amazing, really cool.
I thought so too.
Can't watch it with your kids, but a lot of fun. So I always enjoyed that. And then my kids are so enamored with everything Avengers right now.
It's 101 sketch card.
Stop it. Oh, nice. So cool. And yeah, with this premium release, you're not getting, you know, a black and white sketch card, you know?
Now, while we've got you on the show, Chris, something that we have struggled with, even though we are Marvel fans, 2 things that we would like added 2 cards like this. Number 1, print the artist name.
Yes.
And 2, not everybody is going to know what character that is.
Okay.
Little feedback.
Love it.
Love it.
Because we always like to shout out the artist on the show, tag them on Twitter if at all possible, and I'm not sure.
You know, that is one of the cool things about Marvel products too, is, you know, I see people tagging athletes all the time, and, you know, they don't respond. But if you tag an artist who created your sketch card,
yep,
they'll retweet it, they'll respond, they'll talk to you about it. It's a whole different level of engagement with the sketch card artist for sure. Wow, that's just
totally cool. Vision. Purple Parallel, $1.99 numbering. Awesome.
That is Batroc the Leaper, who is played by Georges St-Pierre in the MCU films.
Thank you, Ivan.
Sketch card.
Doc Ock.
Solved that one all on my own. Didn't even need the chat. Did anyone say it in the chat? Somebody said
Spider-Man. Good job, Ivan.
Oh, Ted Dastic did.
Battle Spectra Gems, Spider-Man versus Mysterio. Wow, that's cool. Look at that.
Yeah, so it's really just, I mean, a ton of this, you know, obviously there's technology in that card, but just the art in particular is just so, like, wow. Each card stands on its own like almost like a mini masterpiece, hence the name.
Hey, funny how that works out, right? Yeah.
Look at how cool that is.
Another Battle Spectra card, Captain America versus Arnim Zola. Oh, it's intense. She-Hulk. How about Tatiana Maslany being named She-Hulk? Yes. Isn't that awesome?
That's going to be a lot of fun to watch.
That's a great Captain America shot there.
Oh, yeah.
Now, I know that in the
preliminary art card,
in the solicitation for this, it was mentioned that years were spent researching, planning compositions by artist Dave Palumbo for 135 oil paintings, which are used here. Do you know what happens to the original paintings? And also, when you say years, like, how early is this product planned out? Like,
yeah, these products are planned out far in advance. And we learned our lesson the first time we brought it back with Joe Gisco. I mean, you don't want to rush them along, you know? And Joe was saying, you know, I need more time. So we were really delayed on that first one, but if you look at the Joe Gisco version of Marvel Masterpieces, it's like, wow. With regard to the original art, I'm not 100% sure, Ivan. I would love to see, you know, them offered up in some type of one-of-one sale, but I'm not sure if the artist keeps them.
Yeah, I was going to say, usually the artists retain rights to the originals.
Well, do they retain rights, or do they get to own it,
but have a deal where they can't actually sell it? And tweet you on that, Ivan.
Okay.
Because I'm interested too.
And then tell me how much money he makes. No, I'm just but everybody always does want, we all want the juicy details.
Yeah.
But yeah, I can only imagine, like, that would be such a cool gallery to go to. You know, in fact, actually, here you go, Chris. Once we can actually, in fact, even before that, now with social distancing, like, my kids did go to a pumpkin patch today.
Awesome.
They monitor how many people can go in. They make sure that they monitor everything. Next Marvel Masterpieces, there has to be a gallery event.
Yeah, it'd be great to do at Comic-Con or Gen Con, another type of event.
Even just locally
nice hit. Canvas Gallery Spider-Man card. Love the texture of this. And look at the awesome art. Like, it's the reflection through the lens of a camera. That's awesome.
Yeah, what I really love is how both our sports and entertainment kind of share technologies. You know, there's really cool things that, you know, you could see stacks coming to hockey. You know, there's a lot of back and forth that occurs there. So the canvas there coming over from the sports side is a cool one.
Venom.
So cool.
Wanted dead or alive, Ghost Rider. That's awesome. Daredevil. And so our last pack
mojo. Let's do it.
Namor. Numbered to $9.99.
So cool.
Is that
a submarine he's shooting out of?
Yeah, right, it looks like it.
So cool.
You just said last pack mojo. Is mojo in this set, Chris?
Oh, I don't know. Oh, that's cool.
And Daredevil Bullseye cover numbered to $1,999.
That's cool.
All right, two winners. One winner gets the sketch card. The other winner gets the two preliminary art cards, the hollow foil Captain America, and the canvas gallery card.
Now, how could I win if I was at home, guys? Just walk us through that.
Ivan, normally, because of Twitter's issues today, but Ivan, explain how we would normally do it. Now we're doing it tonight.
Yeah, normally we do it by retweeting on Twitter. It's a little tough, though. I know that some people are complaining in the chat about switching to Facebook, but I've had three people DM me during the show. Two people tweet me that Twitter is still not working for them.
Well, I'll tell you what, you got better odds. So jump on the old Facebook and make something happen here, folks.
Yeah. So go to facebook.com/goGTSLive. And all you have to do is like the pinned video, the live video of this. It's Inception. Like what you are watching.
You're telling me I could win these amazing cards just by hitting that heart?
You could.
That's right.
That Chris, I'm gonna make sure that you're purposefully excluded. Manufacturer relations issue, I think.
Fine.
We'll send you that Daredevil base card. How does that sound?
There you go. Yes, I like that.
Your friends, your fellow collectors can win just by clicking like on the GoGTS Live Facebook live broadcast of this. Very
easy than that, folks.
Very easy. Yeah, you have to do seven things. Normally, you have to retweet like seven different times to enter to win. You just got to hit like one time.
It's been so long since we had you on, and I can't remember if I've actually done this publicly, but everybody needs to know. Getting Upper Deck products when we're in our first years of the show was a little bit hit or miss. You always took great care of us, but you, Jason, and the entire team went above and beyond to get the Go GTS live show put on a special list called the Quick Ship List. And that means that I get a notification when it's new release week that we have product coming. And so from all of our audience and personally, thank you, Chris, because
no, we love the show. We love what you guys have built here. And it's just, I am a frequent watcher. It's a great way to get news and information about what's happening in the hobby. So kudos to you guys for all the work you put in and all the research you do to bring us the great information of the day. One thing that I did notice was missing that two Upper Deck spokespeople won the NBA championship this week in Mr. LeBron James and Mr. Anthony Davis. So you could find their collectibles at upperdeckstore.com. So exclusive spokespeople, Upper Deck, signed LeBron a long time ago, but we picked up Anthony Davis when he moved to the Lakers, and there's some dual signed stuff there. Those two, and it's really good call, right? And
I think, are you telling me that Anthony Davis is going to be in Goodwin Champions next year?
Yep,
because I've got my LeBron right here.
Yeah, I think so, but there's a lot of new signers to Goodwin Champions coming up, so I'm excited to see that preliminary checklist.
Oh, signers! You took it a step further. I was just thinking base cards, but yeah, I would love some Anthony Davis signatures on Goodwin Champions next year.
Well, my friend. It's always a pleasure having you on. I am so glad we got to do this. I'm so glad that we got to look at three absolutely phenomenal products from a stellar release calendar.
Yeah, that was fun.
Upper Deck has this year. Yeah, I knew you would enjoy that. I held that second box of masterpieces just for you.
Attaboy. So awesome. Thank you guys so much. I really appreciate you having me. And again, if you haven't been collecting hockey, this is one of those special years. You know, you think about Mike Trout's rookie season, you think about Patrick Mahomes' rookie season, you think about LeBron's rookie season, Connor McDavid's rookie season. This is going to be one of those years. So definitely check out Upper Deck Series 1, which will be out mid-November, and a lot of fun hockey releases after that. And the Marvel releases are, again, I think some of the most underappreciated and lower printed types of releases in the market today. So with everything
certainly
that Marvel's
not
doing,
underappreciated here, out. Man.
No, this was, we had some good boxes. That's for sure.
All right, sir. Thank you so much. The one, the only Chris Carlin, friend of the
Thanks,
program.
Guys.
Have a good one.
All right.